There's a new power in the north. The unholy empires of Lego and IKEA have allied and created Big Leg. And yeah, I want to share my opinion on those new Lego storage solutions and that one Lego IKEA set, which we have two of here. Due to having two children, of course, you can just buy one. So, yeah, IKEA launched it on the market in Germany on October 1st, which is quite interesting because on the bottom of the box it says, I think it does not pick up on camera, but copyright 2018, and the manual says 2020 and on the box is there. Interesting. Also they're trying to brand mark the knobs once again. And have the Lego print on it. So, copy patent falling continues, but it's only a German problem as I said. The set and the big box are available for 1461 euros. Makes it 7.2 cents per brick or part. The medium-sized box is 1266, and the set of the three boxes you see here, the small one and the not so small one, with two small ones, so this is 974. So all not quite cheap, but the price per brick for the set is quite okay, and it's like a mixed set with two minifigures, a hot dog, a banana, which the kids were absolutely thrilled with for some reason, which I don't get, but yeah. 2 marks, so quite a basic set. Some people say it's a good launcher set. I think it's not quite good for kids who never have played with Lego at all because you don't have any manuals. So it's quite good for creativity. So if your kids are already familiar with Lego to some degree, it's quite a nice set with an okay price. You will discounted Lego will probably get a little bit cheaper and maybe with a little bit better coloring. So the colors are all over the board. So just the remaining part of the two sets. Let's get the brick separator here. Some small plates. Nothing really fancy, but nothing really offensive either. So some flowers. Since you see, this is what the kids build with it. So kids quite enjoy it. And my idea was like having those boxes for the kids to carry on their Lego in our RV. Let's talk a little bit about the boxes. One thing I really don't like is that the top, the lid is not does not stick. So you have no possibility to get the lid really close. So yeah, it's closed, but you cannot really lock it in place. So this is something I really don't like because, yeah, imagine if you are dropping a big box with 5,000 Legos in it on the floor of your RV or somewhere else. It's just no fun, yeah. Actually, you shouldn't carry so much around. So. On the other hand, the big box, the top is not really super stable, and they're telling you don't step on it. Just waiting for this to happen or waiting when this will happen, so to say. Yeah, and the other thing is they are quite stable, but they are super heavy. So I just measured in this here, this whole assembly here with just the three boxes and the small amount of parts on it is 3 kilograms. For me as an adult, it's really hard to. I can't almost lift it one-handed, and I'm rather strong. So, yeah. Also, if this box would be full, it's really we have no way of really getting a grip on it. So, as a storage solution, I don't think it's that good. If you want to play a hot ice battle and you need some iceberg or something, if you want to include it in your home. Like the dress on the boxes, that's quite okay, but as a storage solution, you can get from IKEA the smaller with a lid. This is like 250 at the moment, and then you put in the base some Lego base plates, and you have the at least same effect, I would say. But it's probably much better and much better And you can get lids for those as well, but I'm not quite sure what they cost. But yeah, it's a much, much cheaper solution. You see what's inside. You can pick them up. They have like a carry handle here. You can put them on top of each other. Much better, because here I have the problem if I put like several of them on top of each other, since I have no carrying handle. Naturally, it would grasp here, but then the box goes up. So I'm not really happy with those boxes. I'm not totally against it, but I wouldn't recommend buying them other than maybe for decorative purposes, or if you have this idea like, yeah, it's good for the kids to have this. But I think from price to usability, you're much better with this. Regarding the sets in Germany, the Lidl Klipse sets are still available, where you get like 1,000 parts for 27 euros at this point. So, but they are much bigger, so for small child, they would not be as good a toy, I would say. But if you just are looking for bricks or looking for play value for money, it's not the best out there. But it's okay in the Lego world, I would say. Figurines with very no special face impression heads. So you have everything here you need to play. So it's a nice creative play set, I would say. The set. So if you're into that, if you're looking for a Christmas present for a 4 to 6 year, maybe 7 year old kid, it's okay for like cheap present. Therefore, it's quite okay. But I wouldn't expect too much of it. The boxes I would more or less avoid, because yeah, I don't see the point really. They would be okay if you could close them, but yeah, I don't see how a kid could carry around this like 1 kilogram box here. If it's full with Lego, for most children, it will be just too heavy. So, thanks for watching, guys. I hope to see you soon. Hope you enjoyed this presentation and was informative for you. So, let me know. Did you ever visit IKEA? Do you know of IKEA? The Nordic Alliance? Is something you're interested in? Thanks for watching, guys. Yeah, I spent all my time IKEA, so of course I had to get this. Bye bye.